Today we will discuss combining skinned meshes. MeshBaker can combine mesh renderer meshes and skinned meshes into combined skinned meshes. Here are some common examples. Many skinned meshes active at once, like this flock of birds or a group of characters, can all be combined together into a single skinned mesh that uses one draw call. Skinned mesh body parts and clothing can be combined dynamically at runtime to create customized characters without rendering extra draw calls for each body part. Regular mesh renderer meshes can be combined with skinned meshes, allowing you to add tools, weapons, or armor to skinned mesh characters without adding extra draw calls. Here is a window that breaks into hundreds of fragments. Normally, all the fragments would be rendered separately using hundreds of draw calls. MeshBaker can combine these renderers into a single skinned mesh so that it uses a single draw call. Combining skinned meshes is very similar to combining regular meshes. The main difference is that the renderer setting should be set to Skinned Mesh Renderer. The following tutorials describe this workflow in detail. See links in the description. Here we will demonstrate the basic workflow using a Texture Baker and Mesh Baker. First, create a Texture Baker and Mesh Baker component. Add source objects to the Texture Baker, either by dragging them to the objects to be combined or using the tools for adding objects. Create an empty asset for the combined material, and bake the atlas that the combined skinned mesh will use. Once that's ready, make sure the renderer setting on the mesh baker is set to Skinned Mesh Renderer. Finally, you can bake the combined mesh, and remember to disable the renderers on the source objects as well. Now there's a combined skinned mesh in the scene. This combined mesh reuses the bones used by the source meshes. Any scripts, animators, triggers, or colliders that move the source bones will now deform the combined mesh exactly as the source meshes were animated. The bone transforms used by the combined mesh in this example belong to several different source prefab instances in the scene. This makes it difficult to create a prefab from this combined mesh. If you want to create a prefab, we recommend using the Bake into Prefab workflow described later in this video. Regular mesh renderers can be combined with skinned mesh renderers. Here we are combining a sword with a skinned mesh character using the same workflow as before. However, there are a few things you should keep in mind when combining mesh renderers and skinned meshes. The combined mesh uses the transform of the source mesh renderer as a new bone. If the sword mesh renderer is a child of the hand game object, then moving the hand will move the sword vertices in the combined mesh. If the sword bone is unparented from the hand and we give it a rigid body and collider, then it can separate from the character and fall to the floor, even though it is still part of the skinned mesh. The sword has added an extra bone. Adding a suit of armor will add a lot of extra bones. Extra bones are slightly more expensive to skin. We can eliminate these by checking No Extra Bones for Mesh Renderers in the Mesh Baker settings. Any source mesh renderers that are children of an existing bone parent will use the existing bone parent. For example, the breastplate vertices will bind to the chest transform, and the helmet vertices will bind to the head transform. A drawback of this feature is that the breastplate and helmet cannot move independently from the head and chest transforms. This feature is useful for the armor parts because they will always move with the character, without the overhead of the added bones. However, this won't work for the sword, because the sword needs to be capable of separating from the hand. We don't want the vertices of the sword to bind to the hand bone. To ensure that the sword does not bind to the hand bone, the sword should not be a child of any bone when we bake. If we position it in the hierarchy like this, then the vertices of the sword will bind to the sword's game object. After baking, we can reparent the sword game object to be a child of the hand bone. It will move with the hand, but still retain its ability to separate. Skinned meshes are more expensive than regular meshes. Before rendering each frame, the vertices of the skinned mesh need to be deformed. Extra work for this deforming step is proportional to the number of vertices added. If a source mesh has a lot of vertices, it may be more performant to not combine it with the skinned mesh. Saving a draw call might not be worth the extra load of the vertex skinning. There are a few common problems you may encounter when combining skinned meshes. Skinned meshes can vanish unexpectedly if the render bounds do not contain all the vertices of the skinned mesh. Here is a skinned mesh character running around. If we look at the render bounds by selecting the mesh, you can see the mesh sometimes moves outside the render bounds. The render bounds are tested against the camera frustum. If the skinned mesh bounds intersect the camera frustum, then there's no issue. But if the camera follows the character and the frustum does not intersect the render bounds, then the skinned mesh will disappear. There are two solutions to this problem. The simple fix is to extend the bounds to cover the entire range of motion of the skinned mesh. the skin mesh will never be outside of the render bounds. The second fix is to use a script to update the render bounds. The range of motion for the skinned mesh may be unknown. The render bounds can be updated dynamically using a script. MeshBaker includes two scripts that do this. One script updates based on the bones of the skinned mesh, and the other script updates based on the bounds of a list of game objects, usually the source game objects. To use one of these scripts, add it to the combined skinned mesh as a component. If you are using the bounds script, you will also have to add the source game objects of the combined skinned mesh. Now you can see the bounds continuously updating as the mesh moves around the scene. Sometimes the combined mesh doesn't animate. This can happen when several skinned mesh characters are combined. Here are several characters, each being animated independently. When the meshes are combined, the animations stop working. The cause of the problem is the location of the animators and the combined skinned mesh renderer in the hierarchy. After combining the skinned meshes, the hierarchy contains three different animators and one skinned mesh renderer. The combined skinned mesh renderer is not a child of any of the animators. The animator's culling mode setting has culled each animation because each animator expects the skinned mesh renderer to be a descendant child of itself. We can fix this by setting the culling mode to always animate for each of the animators. Now the combined skinned mesh will always animate, even if its hierarchy doesn't match what Unity expects. Combined skinned meshes can be saved as prefabs that can be used in other scenes. We strongly recommend using the Bake into Prefab feature on the Mesh Baker, rather than baking into a scene object and making the result into a prefab. We can save our character with his sword as a prefab. To do this, switch the output type on the Mesh Baker to Bake into Prefab. Then, create an empty prefab asset to hold the result. Finally, click Bake on the Mesh Baker. Any errors will appear in the console. If there are none, then the prefab is ready to be used in other scenes. The Bake into Prefab feature ensures all bones and animators are included in the prefab. To do this, it duplicates source bones and animators and moves the duplicates to the combined mesh prefab. Scripts and important rig components may not be copied to the combined prefab if they are too high in the hierarchy. How does MeshBaker decide what to copy? First, it looks for the prefab instance root. If one cannot be found, it then looks for an animator or animation in the bone parents. If neither can be found, it uses the uppermost parent bone. If a complicated source hierarchy is not copying properly, you can create a temporary prefab rooted at the correct game object and use that for the source object. One last thing to note is that MeshBaker can also combine meshes with blend shapes. This is covered in its own tutorial. See the link in the description. MeshBaker is available on the Unity Asset Store. Visit us at digitalopus.ca for more tips and resources for using MeshBaker.